If it's morning, good evening. If it's evening, and good night if it's night. And a big hearty salam alaikum to each and every one of you that's listening to us live or will be listening to us in the archive. I do understand that it is 1 o'clock in the East Coast, but guess what? We are in Central Time now. So we're trying our best to start the show every day at 12 o'clock Central Time. Well, I see there's nobody here with us today, but I'm still going to continue on speaking and playing my music. Well, I got to tell you that things have been moving along quite nicely and smoothly here in Texas, but it is very damn hot. It is so damn hot, child. This heat beats Florida heat. Well, not really. Texas is a dry heat. They say they have humidity, but I haven't felt it yet. But it does get pretty damn hot over here. I see that everything else is going great. We're doing our thing. And hope that everybody's having a great Thursday. I see that none of my friends have yet to hit the lotto because, you know, I don't see anybody flogging on Facebook or anything like that there. But, you know, it is what it is. I'm going to start some new segments on the show. Readings of Pataki, selected prayers, and things of that sort to be able to help people along in their spiritual journey. Oh, I see Mr. Obadala has joined us. How are you, brother? Nice to see you. You got to remember that on the 13th of June, of course, we're coming on St. Anthony's Day, St. Anthony of Padua. Okay, that'll be June the 13th. I want to share something with you guys. So you know who St. Anthony is. Oh, okay. Hi, all. Well, there's not too many people here. I think I got to move it back to 12 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, actually. Hey, hi, Yvette. How are you doing? I'm so happy to have you here with us. Like I say, June the 13th is St. Anthony of Padua's thing. Let me tell you a little bit about St. Anthony. During the 13th century, St. Anthony of Padua preached throughout Italy with his distinct power and eloquence. His sermons denounced corruption, wrongdoing, and injustice. He became renowned as a miracle worker and as a patron saint of the poor and the oppressed. He is depicted in art with an infant Jesus on his arms because of his episode in which a visitor described witnessing St. Anthony of Padua, the patron saint of lovers and marriages. He is often called upon special requests, forgiveness of greed, improvement of memory, and the return of lost articles. So the saint's prayer goes something like this. And remember, what we used to do when we were young, and I still do it now, whenever I lost a certain thing, I would tie a red ribbon around my kitchen table's leg, one of my kitchen table's legs, okay? While petitioning St. Anthony to find whatever it was that I lost, whether it be some money that I stashed, whether it be my car keys, or whether it be a special artifact or whatever, you know, some family heirloom. I'm always losing things. So we would petition St. Anthony again by putting a red string or red ribbon on one of the table legs. Okay? So the prayer goes something like this. Oh, wonderful St. Anthony, glorious on account of the fame of thy miracles, and through the condescending of Jesus is coming in the form of a little child to rest in his arms. Obtain for me of his bounty and grace, which I ardently desire from the depths of my heart. Thou who was so loving towards the miserable sinners, regard not the unworthiness of those who pray to thee, but the glory of God, that it may once again be magnified in the request which I bestow and make upon you. Amen. Remember, that is a prayer to St. Anthony of Padua. He helps people find lost articles and helps people find things of that sort. And also gives forgiveness for greed and unthoughtfulness. Well, we are picking along. We are going along. Of course, I got some things to say or some announcements to make. Hopefully you guys will stick around and hopefully you guys will have fun today, okay? While we're doing this, I know I haven't played a hoodoo song in quite a while. So today I'm going to bring in the Dixie Down on Missouri Street by Arnold Doc Wiley. It's 12 o'clock somewhere. We'll return in 3 minutes and 14 seconds.
There's a little drugstore where the girls and boys go just to pass the time away. If you ever the pretty papas you all chance to meet. I'll tell you what will make you love them so much. They'll find a spot down in your heart that other boys don't touch. At the Dixie drugstore down on Missouri Street. I'm modulating.
When you're sad and lonely, thinking about your only, these few words to you appeal. Take your girl out walking, then she will start talking. Stop her in at Mr. Jack Greenfield. Before you go to see the show, you can hear the radio at the Dixie drugstore down on Missouri Street. Lots of pretty mamas you chance to meet. And if you ever have a heart attack, stop in and have a talk with Mr. Jack at the Dixie drugstore down on Missouri Street.
All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed that, man. That's a little bit of old-time music here being played here today for you guys. Hopefully you enjoyed it. Well, what's going on the internet? Really not too much of anything. I'm kind of surprised. Well, maybe it is because I've, you know, unfriended a multitude of people, and I'm trying to stay out of the bullshit. You know what I'm saying? You know, I've often said this, and I hope that people understand that it's time for us to try to get together. Is that okay? You know, there's so much wrong and so much things going on in the world. You know, I got to tell you, every day, you know, we're accosted with things that are going on. This last weekend, there was a, I believe it happened last month. It wasn't really this last weekend. There was a young white lady who was beat up on a beach by the police. And, you know, she was being belligerent and whatever, you know. But she got her ass whooped by the police and taken to jail. In the course of her getting beat up, I haven't really heard her say it on the video, but people are saying online, okay? I don't mean to say that this actually happened, that she says she was not one of these niggers that people could beat up, that they should be beating up like that. And the funny thing is that this young lady was placed on Good Morning America. So the first thing I wake up to, you know, I before I even get up and, you know, I turn on the TV, I go and wash up and do all my morning stuff. But my bedroom is adjacent to my personal bathroom. So I can hear this lady speaking about her getting beat up with her lawyer and how they're fighting the charges and stuff like that there on Good Morning America. And at first I was like, oh, poor girl. But then I started thinking, I said, Candelo, they do this every day to black and brown people. Every day this happens. Some on video. Some have been shot and killed. Some have been severely beaten, including a famous basketball player just a little while ago. And with exception of the famous basketball player, I have yet to see the marginalized people or the other people get put on a Good Morning America, be spoken about, have give them a platform to say why this was happening and why this was wrong for them. And I sit here and I say to myself, is this them turning a blind eye. Is this saying that this white person was more important than black and brown people? Or is this them saying, well, look, you know, it happens to us too? See, what happens is that I believe if this would have been a black or a brown person, they probably would have been killed. Yvette says, if that's the case, her son would have been on Good Morning America a long time ago. Exactly. I'm going to share with you a story. When I was younger, I was driving, well, actually, I was dropping something off in a company truck, okay? Myself and one of my coworkers, he was driving and I would help him take it down and whatever. So we're in the Miami airport. And he got off and went towards the airport to do whatever he was, and he parked the van. The policeman made me move the van. Mind you, I was only 16. I didn't even have a license. And maybe about 15 or 16. And he made me move the van inside the enclosed garage area or whatever you call it. The van was too high, and he made me drive through it all the time while calling me derogatory names and calling me stuff like that there. And you dumb niggas don't know how to drive and all this kind of shit here. I talked back to him. He snatched me out of the car, roughed me up a little bit, but decided there were too many people around, so he let me get back inside the car and drive. I wonder what would happen if that would have been an African-American who didn't want to be called Leroy or didn't want to be called derogatory names. I just wonder. And it is a shame that this woman got her platform. I'm not mad at her for getting her platform, but I am highly upset that they haven't given anyone else the platform. Well, anyway, it's 12 o'clock somewhere. We'll be right back.
Closer to me, the way you dance is blowing my mind. we're here to do what we want to do for all you rockin' fans. Let's go to work and let's go berserk. You hear a new rhyme every day. But my rap is good in my neighborhood, and I say it just this way. I say, hi ho, I'm on the go. I'm rapping to the beat in stereo. And if you want to know just where to go, everybody just follow me. I said, you listen to the land, it's more easy. That's the one that's moving you viciously. And if you're listening closely, you surely find you listening to the sounds of a mastermind. Hey, hey.
Absolutely happy to be back. Hopefully you guys are enjoying this thing we call, it's 12 o'clock somewhere. I know everybody's getting up and dancing and doing their thing. I see Ben has joined us. I see Nicole has joined us. I see Jeremy has joined us. Welcome one, welcome all to this 12 o'clock somewhere. Please tell your boss to please forgive you for these 60 minutes that you're going to be dancing, hopefully laughing and enjoying and learning a little something. Well, today's tough shit tarot of the day. You're being a little bitch. You're dissatisfied with the outcome of your recent decision. Things didn't go quite as planned. Once you accept responsibility of your choices, you can forgive yourself, grow, and move on. We, as humans, are definitely carrying too much weight on our shoulders, too much baggage. It reminds me of the card, the Anchor, in the Lenormand deck. The Anchor in the Lenormand deck shows us a boat. The boat is on a shore, okay? With a boat that is on the shore, but the anchor is placed more inside the shore boat, so more towards you, okay? The anchor shows us that you can arrive at things with perseverance. You got to try and try and try and try again, okay? But you got to let go of old weight, of old things, so that you may be able to move on, okay? So you got to be able to let go of that anchor. You got to let go. You got to break that anchor so you can be able to go and do what you got to do. It talks about security. It talks about things that are old, that are anchored to a person. It indicates a solution that can be arrived at with perseverance. So you got to keep on trying, but you got to leave that stuff behind you, brothers and sisters, because it is what it is. A lot of times in my readings, I tell people that they need to... especially people that are going through traumas, okay? They need to speak about it, okay? Whether it be to their good friends, to their not good friends, whether it be to a doctor, whether it be to a priest or something like that, but you need to talk about these traumas. Because whether you know it or not, they still are hangers-on. They're anchors that keep you from moving from your spiritual to your spiritual best. Just like that, I'm going to bring on some digital planets. I know you guys haven't heard this in a while. So please do get up off that chair and do your dip. We'll be right back.
flowed straight out of our lids. Them, they got boo bodies, hard rock Brooklyn kids. Us floor rush when they DJ booming classics. You lead the crew on the fattest hip hop record. He touched the kinks and sinks into the sounds. She frequents deep fatter joints called undergrounds. Our funk zooms like you hit the Mary Jane. They flock to booms, man, Boogie had to change. Who freaks the clips with mad amount percussion? Where kinky hair goes to unthought of dimensions? Why is it so fly? Cause hip hop kept some drama. When butterfly rock the light, we sway boomers. What by the cut? We push it off the corner. How was the buzz entire hip hop era? Was fresh and fat since they started saying Audi? Cause funk's made fat from right beneath my hood. The Uber of the styles like Miles and shit. Like 60s funky worms with waves and perms. Just sending junky rhythms right down your block. We beat to rap, what key beat to lock, but I'm cool like that, 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 I'm cool.
We beat the chocolate stacks in my raps. She innovates at the sweet of cat naps. He at the funk club with the vibrate. Then they be crazy down with the five feet. It can't kick a plan with the crowd burst. Me, I be digging it with the bug first. Us, we be freaking till dawn, peace and I. Yes, a stranger smiles, so I say hi. Who understood? Yeah, understood the plans. Him heard a beat and put it to his hands. What I just flipped, let border get loose. How to consume all the beaches like juice. If it's the shit, we'll lift it off the plastic. The babes will go spastic, hip-hop is a classic. Pimp playing sharp, it don't matter, I'm fatter. Axe butter how I zone.
Man, Cleopatra Jones.
And I'm chill like that, I'm chill like that. I'm chill like that, I'm chill like that. I'm chill like that, I'm chill like that. I'm chill like that, I'm chill.
I got crew kids, seven and a crescent. Us cause a buzz when a nickel bets a dealt. Him, that's my man with the asteroid belt. They catch a fizz from the Mr. Doodle Big. He rocks a tee from the Brooklyn Nine Pigs. The rebirth is slick like my gangster stroll. The lyrics just like Luke coming stacks and rolls. You used to find the bug in a box with Dave. Now he boogies up your stage, plats twist the braids. And I'm peace like that, I'm peace like that. I'm peace like that, I'm peace like that. I'm peace like that, I'm peace like that. Like that. I'm
check it out, man. I groove like that. I'm smooth like that. I jive like that. I roll like that.
Yeah, I'm thick like that. I stack like that. I'm down like that. I'm black like that.
Yo, I funk like that. I'm fat like that. I'm in like that because I swing like that.
We jazz like that. We freak like that. We zoom like that. We out. We out. We out.
Guys, today I got to put on you the thing that you guys got to find out, you know, ladies and gentlemen, have to find out about the plants and the trees that are around you. I'm an advocate of that, always getting out there and finding out what tree is this and what tree is that. When I moved here almost a month and a half or 2 months ago, I've already paid rent twice, so I guess I've been here for 2 months. I walk outside the first couple of days I was here and the wind was blowing. And there were a whole bunch of white things flying all the way around my home and in my yard and basically the whole damn neighborhood. And I was saying, my God, what a beautiful tree. What a beautiful tree that is in front of my house. It gets covered with these white things that looks like cotton. And every time the wind blows, these things fly all over the neighborhood. I found out later that it was called a cottonwood tree. And I also found out that this is an ancestral tree for many Geechee and Gullah people. Gullah, sorry. The ancestral mothers would go around it and give offerings to the tree and do things around the tree. And I was taken aback and I said, my goodness, this is why this tree talks to me. This is why I feel this tree is an ancestral tree that people would use in their ancestral offerings, bring their new babies there, do rituals around the tree. And it kind of reminded me of this one story that Changodina told me a lot of years ago about the ceiba tree. In Cuba, there was a particular house that had a humongous ceiba tree with a big chain around it. People swore that the tree, the chain around the tree, would grow every year as the ceiba grew. The people that lived inside the home before, well, the descendants of the people that lived inside the home were spiritual. They were very spiritual. They were Orisha priests, and they were also paleros and ganguleros into Palo Mayumbe. So this tree would have birthday parties. Every year they would give a ceremony to this tree where they would feed the tree, they would sacrifice something in front of the tree, and they would bring toys, and they would have a feast for the tree. Lo and behold, as the years went by, families start forgetting tradition. And all things around the house started going berserk. People started getting sick. People started dying. Tragic accidents and things of that sort. So they finally decided to go get a spiritualist. Or a spiritualist to come over and check it out and see why was this tree... I mean, why was these things happening? And the guy says, well, you know, what's happening is that this tree is a living entity. They were used to, it was used to, people giving it offerings once a year and having this big ritual and this big thing for it. And, you know, he wants his rituals back. So, lo and behold, they got someone to start, you know, doing the rituals again. And the tree still stands there with the chain around it. And everything stopped. So while I was contemplating all this, see, because I, you know, once I found out what the tree was and the gift that it gives, I started saying to myself, what do you want? What do you want, beautiful, majestic cottonwood plant? And she said, tie ribbons around me. Different color ribbons. Different color ribbons on my branches. So I started today. I put a couple of ribbons on there. A couple of colored ribbons. I don't want my neighbors to think I'm nuts. But I can hear and I can feel the tree rejoicing. Now, let me ask you. What's in your backyard? What type of magical, medicinal, spiritual tree do you have in your backyard? Or in your front yard? Or in your neighborhood? These trees have stories to tell. Lives to save. Spirituality to give. We'll be right back.
Negro, que me dé la mano. Tiene que ser negro fino, blanco que me dé la mano. Tiene que ser mayombero como yo.
Negro que me dé la mano.
Que me dé la mano.
Tiene que ser negro fino.
Negro fino.
Blanco que me dé la mano.
Que me dé la mano.
Tiene que ser mayombero como yo.
Ay, negro que me dé la mano. Tiene que ser gallo fino, blanco que me dé la mano. Tiene que ser mayombero como yo.
Negro que me dé la mano.
Que me dé la mano.
Tiene que ser negro fino.
Negro fino.
Blanco que me dé la mano.
Que me dé la mano.
Tiene que ser mayombero como yo.
negro que me dé la mano, tiene que ser gallo fino, blanco que me dé la mano, tiene que ser gango.
Ese tema, agua San Miguel Candela Brava.
Agua, que se quema, agua San Miguel Candela Brava.
Agua, que se quema, agua San Miguel Candela Brava.
San Miguel, agua San Miguel, candela brava.
Agua que se quema, agua San Miguel, candela brava.
Y agua que se quema, agua San Miguel, candela brava.
Agua que se quema, agua San Miguel, candela brava.
Y agua San Miguel.
Coronado allá arriba,
arriba
los seres que están coronados allá arriba, arriba los seres que están coronados allá arriba,
arriba
los seres que están coronados allá arriba,
arriba los seres que están coronando allá arriba,
arriba
los seres que están coronando allá arriba,
arriba
los seres que están coronando allá arriba. I'm so happy to have y'all back, man. Let me tell you something. I'm doing something this summer, and I hope y'all all are ready. I'm babysitting this summer. It'll be $30 per child, EBT approved. I tell you, I whip all kids. You don't show up. If you don't show up, I drop them off. My services start at 7 a.m. and end at 7 p.m. I will provide breakfast and lunch, but I am not providing dinner, so pick up your kids on time. If your baby drinks formula and you don't bring enough, he or she will be drinking Kool-Aid or sugar water. Little boys will have their heads examined at the door so I can look at the shape of it and tell you if they are bad or not any child. And I will also not accept children with silver caps on their teeth. They'll be automatically denied. Little girls with braids or crochets will cost a little extra, because we already know that there's women trapped in little girls' bodies. I hope your child can fight, because if he don't, I don't get into house business, and I don't break up fights. So I hope that you guys understand where I'm standing at this year with my taking care of children. Okay, I got to tell you that the time is approaching, guys. Believe it or not, September is right there, okay? September is right there, and guys, get ready for the Conjure Gala. The Mile High Conjure Gala is almost here, guys. Get your tickets. It is worth every damn penny, okay? You're going to have, of course, myself there. I'll be giving a class on pinwheel magic. Man, if you've never seen this class, man, believe me, you're going to get a hell of a class. And after I do the Mile High Conjure Gala, and I also make my appearance at Omaha, Nebraska, we'll be I'll be making a video series about it, and I'll be teaching you guys how to do it, okay? So that's what we're going to be doing. I got to tell you guys, I'm also going to bring along a variety of different candles for my friend Misty Salas, okay? From Misty's Mysticals Candles, I believe it's called. Befriend her on Facebook, guys. She honestly has some of the best handmade, hand-poured candles I have seen in a long time, okay? I'm working with her now to make my signature, to mold my signature reverse candles, okay? They're going to have sigils on them. They're going to be looking great. They're going to be sold at the My Heart Conjure Gala first, and then they'll be sold around things. I'm also getting a variety of candles from her that I will be selling at the Conjure Gala, okay? I also want you to check out my friend Yvette, the Motown Witch, okay? She has a wonderful website. It has a wonderful actual brick-and-mortar store in Detroit, okay, guys? So check it out at themotownwitch.com. Also, please do check out our good friend, sister, our war dog, Ifa Abeyu. Ifa Abeyu has Love Supply Botanica. I believe that it's in Brooklyn, but it's somewhere in New York. So go do check her out, guys. Do make that a part of your thing. Remember, one hand washes the other and both wash the face. Guys, remember, do not be that person. See, because Elijah Muhammad taught us that, a lot of times we are so, racism and bigotry and all this is even instilled inside of us in a certain way, but not towards other races, but towards ourselves and our people, okay? He says that there were two people selling ice on a corner. There was one black one and one white one. The people would automatically go to the white one thinking that the white one's ice was cleaner. Let me tell you something. Both ices were made in the same place. Okay? Both ices were made in the same place. The only thing is that one person is black and the other person is white. And people automatically think that you buy the ice from the white man, it would have been cleaner. Well, in hoodoo, in conjure, in these spiritualities, in Santeria, in Ifa, and all these things, I would tell you that you need to buy things from your community. You got to help your community. Okay? Each one helps one, and each one builds one. Okay? So that's where I stand with that. So, let's start, let's play a little bit of music, guys, because I want you to get up and dance and do your thing. This one is definitely dedicated to our sister, our war dog, our friend, hopefully someday your godmother, Ifa Abeyu, in Love Supply Botanica. Now, sister, you got on up and pump it up, because people, they tell me, that, when people are walking inside the stores and they hear Candelo Kimbisa, they say, damn, who's that fine ass? No, I'm just playing. They said your name on the radio. Listen, up, turn it up, and dance with Mama Chola. We'll be right back.
La la la, Chola. La la la, Chola. Chola con tanta manilla y yo no tengo dinero.
La la la, Chola. La la la, Chola. Chola con tanta manilla y yo no tengo dinero.
La la la, Chola. La la la, Chola. Chola con tanta manilla y yo no tengo dinero.
La la la, Chola. La la la, Chola. Chola con tanta manilla y yo no tengo dinero.
La la la, Chola. La la la, Chola. Chola con tanta manilla y yo no tengo dinero.
La la la, Chola. La la la, Chola. Chola con tanta manilla y yo no tengo dinero.
La la la, Chola. La la la, Chola. Chola con tanta manilla y yo no tengo dinero.
La la la, Chola. La la la, Chola. Chola con tanta manilla y yo no tengo dinero.
La la la, Chola. La la la, Chola. Chola con tanta manilla y yo no tengo dinero.
La la la, Chola. La la la, Chola. Chola con tanta manilla y yo no tengo dinero.
Chola tanta manilla
y yo no tengo dinero.
Chola con tanta manilla
y yo no tengo dinero.
Chola huengue con tanta manilla
y yo no tengo dinero.
Chola con tanta manilla
y yo no tengo dinero.
Chola con tanta manilla
y yo no tengo dinero.
Mamá chola con tanto dinero, manilla de oro, su cuerpo sin nada.
Mamá chola con tanto dinero, manilla de oro, su cuerpo sin nada.
Mamá chola con tanto dinero, manilla de oro, su cuerpo sin nada.
Mamá chola con tanto dinero, manilla de oro, su cuerpo sin nada.
Mamá chola con tanto dinero, manilla de oro, su cuerpo sin nada.
Mamá chola con tanto dinero, manilla de oro, su cuerpo sin nada.
Mamá chola con tanto dinero, manilla de oro, su cuerpo sin nada.
Mama chola
con tanto dinero, manilla de oro, su cuerpo sin nada.
Mama sandal, mama chola, mayumbe,
lango
va a correr. Chola wenge, a wenge chola. Chola wenge, a wenge chola.
Chola wenge, a wenge chola. Chola wenge, a wenge chola.
Chola wenge, a wenge chola. Chola wenge, a wenge chola.
Chola wenge, a wenge chola.
Chola, chola caminando.
Chola wenge, a wenge chola.
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 Mama chola, chola caminando.
Chola wenge, a wenge chola.
Chola, chola caminando.
Chola wenge, a wenge.
Mama chola,
niña linda, niña linda, niña linda, la mama chola.
Niña linda, niña linda, niña linda, la mama chola.
Niña linda, niña linda, niña linda, la mama chola.
Niña linda, niña linda, niña linda, la mama chola.
Niña linda, niña linda, niña linda, la mama chola.
Niña linda, niña linda, niña linda, la mama chola.
Niña linda, niña linda, niña linda, la mama chola.
Chola, mamá chola, pirindingo te está esperando, pirindingo te está esperando, pirindingo te está esperando.
Mamá chola, pirindingo te está esperando.
Pirindingo, pirindingo, pirindingo te está esperando.
Mamá chola, pirindingo te está esperando.
Mamá chola, chola wengue, pirindingo te está esperando.
Mamá chola, pirindingo te está esperando.
Chola wengue, wengue chola. Pirindingo te está esperando.
Mamá chola, pirindingo te está esperando.
Pirindingo, pirindingo, pirindingo te está esperando.
Mamá chola, pirindingo te está esperando.
Pirindingo te está esperando. Pirindingo te está esperando.
Mamá chola, pirindingo te está esperando.
Pirindingo, mamá chola, pirindingo te está esperando.
Mamá chola, pirindingo te está esperando.
Niña
linda con tanta manilla,
con tanta manilla yo sin ninguna.
Ella linda con tanta manilla,
con tanta manilla yo sin ninguna.
Ella linda con tanta manilla,
con tanta manilla yo sin ninguna.
Ella linda con tanta manilla,
con tanta manilla yo sin ninguna.
Ella linda con tanta manilla,
con tanta manilla yo sin ninguna.
Ella linda con tanta manilla,
con tanta manilla yo sin ninguna.
Ella linda con tanta manilla,
con tanta manilla yo sin ninguna.
Ella linda con tanta manilla,
con tanta manilla yo sin ninguna.
Ella linda con tanta manilla,
mamá chola yo sin ninguna.
Ella linda con tanta manilla,
manilla yo sin ninguna.
Ella linda con tanta manilla,
mamá chola yo sin ninguna.
Ella linda con tanta manilla,
mambe.
Yo, man, I almost forgot that we were almost to the end of the show. So, guys, thank you, thank you, thank you for coming in and sharing and being with us here at It's 12 O'Clock Somewhere every day at 12 o'clock. Guys, I absolutely appreciate you. I would appreciate it more if you like and share this page, share this show, like it and share it to your respective pages. Man, remember, one hand washes the other and both wash the face. As always, may all the egoons and shadows that accompany you have all the necessary light. From where I sit, that's it. Salam alaikum, everyone.
Birds flying high, you know how I feel. Sun in the sky, you know how I feel. Breeze drifting on by, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day. It's a new life for me, yeah. It's a new dawn, it's a new day. It's a new life for me. Ooh. And I'm feeling good. Fish in the sea, you know how I feel. River running free, you know how I feel. Blossom on the tree, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me, and I'm feeling good. Dragonfly out in the sun, you know what I mean, don't you know? Butterflies all having fun, you know what I mean? Sleep in peace when day is done, that's what I mean. And this old world is a new world, and a bold world for me. When you shine, you know how I feel. Scent of the pine, you know how I feel. Oh, freedom is mine, and I know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me.
It's 12 O'Clock Somewhere is brought to you by Love Supply Botanica, TheMotownWitch.com, Kimbisa.org, The Mile High Conjure Gala, and of course, ProfessorPorterfield.com.